Welcome to Sitam Church Online. This is Reverend Jotham Munene from Sitam Mombasa, and I'm glad you're joining me for this series we are doing, The Cry for the Boy Child. Have you noticed that the boy child looks like an endangered species, and is there hope? Those are the questions we'll be grappling with for the next several videos. Today we want to show that this has been a long project from the enemy to diminish and to put down the boy child, but there is hope in the Lord. Welcome. Jeremiah chapter 31, I want to read verse 15. A voice was heard in Ramah, lamentation and bitter weeping, Rachel weeping for her children, refusing to be comforted for her children because they are no more. If you look at the Young Literal Translation, he says Rachel is crying for her sons. And of course, Rachel is the mother of Israel. And if those of you who have read the Bible a lot, especially in the New Testament, towards the Gospels, you find that that cry was attributed to the mothers of Israel when Herod had killed the boys. You remember Herod, because he did not want Jesus to take his throne, so that he eliminates any threat to his throne, he decided to kill all the boys that were 2 years and under, as we find in Matthew chapter 2. And so there is a cry there for the mothers, and this was prophesied in a way by Rachel. So the enemy has been killing the boy. If you go to, in fact, the beginning of the Bible, you have Adam and Eve, and then you have Abel and Cain kills Abel, and again, a boy child to start with has been killed. You go to Exodus chapter 1, and there you find the Pharaoh of Egypt says to the midwives that whenever a boy is being delivered, an Israeli boy, if it is a boy, kill him. If it is a girl, let him live. That has been an agenda of the enemy to get rid and kill the boy child, because you see the boy child is very important. He carries the seed, and he has also leadership, responsibilities given by God. So if you keep looking, and we will be looking at other areas in history again, and we realize that the boy child is always under threat, and we want today to be able to encourage the boy child and also to find ways where we can work with God to preserve these people and help them to be a blessing to society. Now, Herod had said, and I'm going to read from the book of Exodus, as I've just said, to the midwives, that will kill the boys. This is how he said. We are in Exodus chapter 1, verse 15. The king of Egypt is saying to the Hebrew midwives, and their names were Shifra and Pua. Those are good names for girls. When you are helping the Hebrew women during childbirth on the delivery stool, if you see the boy, that the baby is a boy, you are to kill him. But if it is a girl, let her live. The midwives, however, feared God, and they did not do what the king of Egypt had told them to do. So the Bible says in verse 20, that so God was kind to the midwives, and the people increased, and they became even more. And because the midwives feared God, he gave them families of their own. Today I want to call upon you, my viewer, to be those midwives, to be Shifra and Pua, and do certain things. Refuse the voice of Pharaoh. Pharaoh is a type of Satan that says, kill the boy child. Here are some of the things that we can do to be those midwives. Number one, the boy child is being killed through abortion.
I know the girl child also is killed, but it's only that this time we are focusing on the boy child. You can stop abortion. You can speak against abortion. You, as a doctor, you as a nurse, you as a medic, can refuse to be engaged in abortion. And in some places, actually, what we are also calling infanticide, where the baby is actually killed in the beginning, if you after they are born. Now, if you kill these children, how do you know that their destiny, what their destiny is? And who gave you the right to take away the life of these people? So be like the midwife and say, even though the king of this world, the enemy, is saying that we kill, I'm not going to do it. Number two, if you are a young man, if you got somebody pregnant, don't push the girl to procure an abortion, because you are now following the rules of Pharaoh. Say, let the child live. If you are a parent, do not ask your children to procure an abortion. The other way we can do is do not kill the self-image of the boy child, because some of us have done that. If you are a teacher, if you are a parent, if you are a leader in some way, make sure that you do not continue abusing them and killing their self-image. Lastly, if you are a politician, do not kill the boy child by exposing them to your own political games, to take them out there in demonstrations and all kinds of risky activities. It is usually the boy child that finds themselves in such activities and they get killed. We want to preserve our boy child. Do not accept to be the one to take away their life. I hope you can join me in this cry for the boy child and in helping. You have been watching Sitam Church Online. My name is Jotham Munene, and I'm glad you are watching. Now, in case you have questions, in case you want to make a contribution, please send us a link through the available social platforms down. Thank you.